Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today we are going to create stairs onto stomping ground in ARCHICAD. All right, let's get started. At the very first, we are going to change the unit system from the project preferences. We click the working units and in the length unit, we click the millimeter, change to centimeter, and we click the OK. Now we work with centimeter. And for this tutorial, at the very first, we are going to create some sloping ground. So that we are going to use mesh tool. We have mesh tool over here. Let's click that. And from the geometry method, let's create some rectangular area. Something like this. Okay, now we have our plot area. And onto that we are going to create our splines. For splines, I prefer using and recommend you the spline tool. We have spline tool, and from geometry method it's not important, but you click and with that we create splines randomly. Maybe you may have your own areas, on spline areas for your project. You can just use your project splines and arrange your levels according to your project. Okay, once we have it, let's go back to the 3D window. And we have a straight plot area. We are going to give some more thickness for our landscape, but for the thickness, we are not going to use this thickness value. We are going to use elevation coordinates. We can just click the corners and you will see this elevate mesh point. If we click that, we can, well, something like this, change the elevation. And we can, of course, input a value here. You can see the Z coordinate. For instance, you can input here 4 meters. 4 meters will be calculated from this blue line to this top point. But I'm not going to do this. Let's go back. And I'm going to use these splines. And I'm going to give this spline path to 1 meter. This is going to be 2 meter. And this is 3. And the top points for the mesh will be 4 meter, and this is going to be 0. To do that, we click the mesh. It's important. We click the mesh and still clicked. After that, we go to mesh tool again and we hit the space. Do not leave the space and click the spline. And after that, we are going to select fit to user ridges and click OK. You will see points will be inserted onto our mesh. Let's continue. Mesh still selected and this mesh tool still selected. Hit the space, click OK, click OK. All right. Let's go back to 3D window. And you will see we have points and stairs still on the same level. Let's change that. We are going to change that from the floor plan, not in the 3D window. To do that, we are going to, well, we can now get rid of the splines, or you can give them hidden layers so that you can use them later. And we click the mesh. And we click the points and you will see the only points of this spline will be selected, not this one. If you click this point, you will see these points will be also selected. We don't want to select them. We only want to select this spline's point so that we click the center point anywhere in the mesh or mesh. Anyway, let's click the point and click the elevate mesh point, and we are going to input a value here. It says height, so we input here 100 centimeters, not meter. And apply to all. If we click apply to all, the all visible points will be changed to 100 centimeters. From the mesh reference plane, you can change this according to your selection or choice. Let's click OK. As you can see, the difference from this level to this level is 1 meter. Let's continue. Let's make this 2 meters. Hit enter. Click here. Input here. 3 meters. And this point is going to be 4 meters. But for that, we are not going to click apply to all. If you click apply to all, this point will be set up to 4 meters. So we won't click the apply to all here. We input here 4 meters. Also same here. And this will be stay at 0, and this one also. Let's go to 3D window, and this is what we have. We are doing well, but for this slope, I can change this point's height to this direction with eyeball. And also for this one also. By the way, if you want to get rid of these inner segments, you can go to the floor plan and section over here. And we have show all ridges. Let's change that. Show user defined ridges. Let's click that. And they are gone, but in the floor plan. We also have one more option to change that in the settings. All the ridges smooth. There we go. All right, let's come back to the main title of the tutorial. We are going to create stair for this sloped ground. At the very first, I'm going to create one terrace here. So we use slab tool. Simple structure, rectangle, and terrace. And after that, I'm going to change this elevation line and turn this into a section. Right click and click to open with current view settings. And I'm gonna change the elevation of this slab. Something like this. And I can change the thickness of the slab, maybe 60 centimeters. And once we have that, we are going to create an additional terrace for the project. Maybe it's going to be somewhere here. And from the east elevation, I'm going to change its elevation also. And click the M key at your keyboard. Hold the shift and click the second. You will see distance is 1. Okay. I want this to be at around 2 meters, so let's fit there. Top height and move 2 meters upside, and after that, I'm going to change the elevation of this spline. This is 1, 2, second. Let's click the second one. and add an additional 1 meter. Let's do this. Maybe 20 centimeters more, 320. Very nice. Let's continue. And maybe this one is going to be 4 meters. Yeah, makes sense. Now we have our slab under terrain. We can fix it using solid element operation. We add this as an operator. It's going to be target subtraction with upwards. We can make something like this, or let's go back and we can add points around this slab with the same method, and after that we can change the elevation of that points. So the previous method is the same method. We click the mesh and click here, make a rectangle, fit to user edges. There we go. Now we have points in the 3D window also. Let's click the point and fit here. Maybe we can fit here too. This one also. Wonderful. Now, once we have all of these, we can go to stair tool and let's change the width and change the baseline to center. Start from here and let's end to here, but we cannot see the second slab. In order to see that our second slab, we are going to change the visibility of the second slab in the settings. Let's click the slab and hit the Ctrl plus T. And we have home story. Home story will be stay at the ground floor. But if we click directly ground floor, you will see to project 0 will be changed. I didn't like this. I want this to stay at previous number. So let's go back, and this time we are going to copy this and go to click the ground floor, select this and paste. So the project 0 will be stay at the same, and home story is going to be ground floor. As you can see, elevation wasn't changed. And on the ground floor, now we can see it. Now we can arrange our stair according to this project. But I want to change this length of the stair, but I cannot. It's moving with the blue line also. To fix that, we go to settings and we have we uncheck the limitations and click OK again. Now we would change the blue line with this move node. It didn't happen. We have one more option in the settings. This one. These limitations will be also unchecked. Let's try again. Yeah. There we go. Now we can change the stair treat length. Let's change the section position. Let's fix the elevation of the stair. By the way, I'm sorry for my voice. I'm a little sick. So I don't want to speak so much. Sorry. As you can see, we can change the stair position from the elevation. But at the very first, I want to get rid of this wooden parts, finishings. Is 5 centimeter. So I'm going to input here 5 centimeter, and they will stick together. But in the 3D window, we have gaps under the stair. So to fix that, you can guess, we will add points and change the elevations. Let's try that in the 3D window. Let's click the mesh and click the mesh here, both of them. Select it, hit the space, click the stair. And it didn't happen. For the slab it happens, but not for stair. So we go to ground floor and, well, you can add points with this method. 1 point here, 1 point here, or you create the mesh. This one you will select and make a rectangular shape. And 8 points. Now we have points added. And now we can change their position according to our stair. Okay guys, in the end I get something like this. I change the stair width and added some railings onto that. I changed the terrace and added some chairs and tables and something like that. I wanted to show why slope plant and stair is important for this example. I hope you have learned something new. If so, please hit the like button and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.